Believe me, Christchurch has got a pretty lively music scene. Covers everything from the hard edge of Hammerack to the jazz glam, you name it, of Into the Void, and even student radio favourites Dolphin. Yep, Christchurch really has got it all.
Like the other three main centres, Christchurch contributed a great deal to the explosion in New Zealand music in the first half of the 1980s. It was where bands like Pop Mechanics, Hip Singles, The Narcs, and most of all, the Dance Exponents, launched their assaults on the charts. And it was the fertile breeding ground for people like The Bats, They Were Expendable, Jean-Paul Sartre, and NRA, as well as producing oddities like The Axemen and The Eclectic Club. When Radio with Pictures visited in 1982, Christchurch had a healthy live scene that in production values alone was the envy of other cities. Bands there had bigger PAs and better lighting, but best of all could afford to live off their music.
The bands that are more conscious they want success are quite competitive here. The bands that are simply more interested in just making music would help each other, even come to lend in equipment and so on. But some of the other bands are, there's a clique of bands though. I mean, yeah, I think all the bands will help each other one way or the other, but there certainly are very strong competition. Yeah.
Healthy competition?
Yeah, it doesn't hurt, I don't think. Yeah, it's healthy competition that doesn't hurt. That's what we've got here.
7 years later, there's not much of that healthy live competition left, although Christchurch still produces some of the country's top young bands, as well as being home to The Bats, Delta Space, and Reinach Award winners Breathing Cage. So many of the great Christchurch bands have left the city for greener pastures in the North Island, Jean-Paul Sartre being the most recent example. So how do the bands who've stayed survive? And what future is there for the young bands of Christchurch?
Why do Breathing Cage remain in Christchurch? Well, personally, I don't need to be in a city such as Auckland to write songs. All I need is an empty house. And for the other members, I couldn't say, but I know I quite like a less stressful city to live in, but I enjoy visiting larger cities.
One thing I'd like to say is that I don't think a lot of Christchurch bands get national recognition as do bands who are based in Auckland or Wellington. You know, there's some good bands here, Belka Space, Breathing Cage, and a lot of newer bands, Catherine Wheel, Into the Void. You know, there are a lot of good bands here that nobody's ever heard about up north.
We knew there was only one thing for us, and that was to give away Gary Glitter albums on stage.
One of our big ambitions.
It's almost like we've cornered a market.
We wouldn't play at the Subway because they're not into colour down there.
It's a band that's got together and is just into having a good time, I'd say.
There's a positive attitude in sort of the music scene around Christchurch at the moment, because people have decided, like, we've got to get it together and actually, you know, achieve aims and ambitions. I mean, you invest time into it. The reason Christchurch bands haven't really been heard is because they haven't been recorded and they haven't sort of gone about seeking to have their music sort of played around the country. We recorded a 6-song cassette EP, which is kind of a demo thing, which we sent around the student radio stations.
Nights a week, just surviving at this stage. We need a bit more promotion, get the name out a bit, maybe go around New Zealand, play a few pubs, just get the name out, get a few more venues, a bit more of a following.
If I get maybe an album or something, if make it worthwhile touring then, and get the word around that way.
In Christchurch, it is fairly difficult for us to get a gig because nobody likes us. Because we say rude words.
I don't think that's true.
Okay, we're really popular and it's really easy to get a gig.
Most popular bands in the town.
It's really easy.
Garden of heaven, the devil in his core. Hustling for a piece of your unclean store.
No, I don't think the Christchurch live scene is any better. And in fact, I think it's worse now than it has been for a really long time. I can't really say that Christchurch bands sound alike because I don't think they do. There's a big difference. There's no one making a living out of original music in Christchurch that I know of. The situation in Christchurch, I feel, is quite positive and focused. The bands are sort of getting an idea of where they're going and taking their time about getting there, thinking about it before they do it, which is a change from the way it used to be.
Well, at the moment, the Prodigies are fairly well known around the South Island. We've done a couple of tours here, and we're going to be heading up to Auckland. Wellington, late November, to record an EP up at Mascot.
Christchurch's been going through a fairly down patch for the last 2 years, and in the last 6 months it's really picking up. There's a lot of really good bands coming out now. It's all starting to go ahead.
The new generation.
Now for something completely different.
Well, it started out with Mark and Jason. They together bought a couple of guitars and they used to play. They called themselves the Deaf Mutants. And they ended up coming up to the practice rooms they used to play up here, and I started having a few plays with them, and then Ronnie turned up and picked up a microphone, and all of a sudden we were a band.
You sort of two categories. You have the older sort of bands, like the older kind of Flying Nun sounding bands. Then I think you've got a kind of a new emerging type of band. Sort of younger people, I think.
We're sort of a paradox in that situation because we're older, but we're not that older sound, and so we don't really fit into that scene because we're not, like at our age, if we'd been playing music, we'd be, I don't know, really competent. But probably we don't, I mean, that's not what we're trying to do. We're not trying to write pop songs. We don't want to be R.E.M.
One leg too short, a kind of busy as we want to be, but it's a matter of whether you do want to play all the time, and we're always fooling around with different ideas and different songs, so, you know, we play when we want to play, and there's lots of there's lots of support from councils and community groups to get us going playing in different places rather than pubs or anything like that. It's quite a bit of work to do, if you want to do it.
Perry's Occidental, a really well-known Christchurch landmark. I've spent many long nights here drinking and grooving to the band.
I don't doubt it.
For sure.
Yeah?
You know an awful lot for a taxi driver.
Hey. Have you left the meter running?
Oh, God.
Anyway, Prince Mania has gone hand-in-hand with Bat Mania lately, it seems. The party man himself needs no induction.